Hey, what's up, everybody? What's up? This is Jeff from BKJmacTV, and this is the official BKJmacTV podcast experience. And this is season 2, episode 39. Yes, episode 39. And this episode, we are in celebration. We are in celebration because a woman who basically made a false accusation back in 1955 in Mississippi has finally died. This woman was evil as sin, and until her death, she still continued to lie, and she still continued to avoid accountability for her actions. So her soul and body is in a different resting place in hell, where it actually belongs. This woman is in hell. So you're probably wondering, who am I talking about? This is from the Associated Press. The woman I'm talking about is Carolyn Brian Dunham. Basically, she was the woman that got Emmett Till lynched back in 1955. The article titled, "Carolyn Brian Dunham, who accused Emmett Till before he was lynched, dies at age 88. This piece of garbage lived until she was 88 years old. And yeah. And she got Emmett Till killed. Here's the story. Basically, Jackson, Mississippi. The white woman who accused black teenager Emmett Till of whistling at her, causing his 1955 lynching in Mississippi, which galvanized a generation of activists to rise up in the civil rights movement, has died at 88. Carolyn Brian Dunham died in hospice care Tuesday night in Westlake, Louisiana, according to a death report filed Thursday in the Cascoosa Parish Coroner's Office. Her death marks the last chance for anyone to be held accountable for kidnapping and brutal murder that shocked the world. Till's mother, Mamie Till Mobley, insisted on an open casket funeral in their hometown of Chicago so the world could see her 14-year-old son's mutilated body, which was pulled from a river in Mississippi. Jet Magazine published photos. Basically, I've watched this series, Women of the Movement. I've seen the photos, the Jet Magazine photos. What those monsters, what Carolyn and her disgusting piece of garbage of a husband and his brother did was disgusting. It was heinous what they did to Emmett Till. And guess what? Miss Mamie Till Mobley kept fighting. She didn't give up. She kept fighting until she was able to prove that they did it. But the courts in Mississippi, who were extremely racist, would not convict the two white men of the murder. That was sad, and it was disgusting. But she never gave up, and she continued a legacy of fighting, and she passed away in 2002. You know, she just never gave up. But the story is about this disgusting woman, Carolyn Brian Dunham, the monster who is now in hell right now for what she did back in 1955. In August 1955, Till had traveled from Chicago to visit relatives in Mississippi. Donham, then 21 and named Caroline Bryan, accused him of making improper advances on her at a grocery store where she was working in the small community of Money. The Rev. Wheeler Parker, a cousin of Till who was there, has said Till whistled at the woman, an act that flew in the face of Mississippi's racist social codes of the era. Evidence identifies a woman identified Till to Dunham's then husband Roy Bryan and his half-brother J.W. Mellum, who killed the teenager. An all-white jury acquitted the two white men in the killing, but the men later confessed in an interview with Look magazine. That was the disgust. That was the heinous part. After they were cleared of the murder charges, they basically were so-called exonerated because when the Founding Fathers were creating the Constitution, and one constitutional amendment is that if you were not convicted, you could not face double jeopardy. So, in essence, these two monsters, Roy and J.W., were able to get away because of the Constitution. Even though they knew they did it and they got away with murder and whatnot, they could not be brought up for charges at that county because of double jeopardy rules. And the fact that they confessed how they killed Emmett Till in Look magazine for, I think it was $25,000 or $50,000, was extremely heinous and disgusting. And at least all three of them are all dead now, and their spirits are in hell. A Till relative says Dunham's death brings mixed emotions. When Till disappeared in Mississippi, Ole Gordon, one of Till's cousins, was 7 years old and living in the Chicago home with Till's mother and family. Gordon told the Associated Press on Thursday that in the days following when he went missing, the home was full of fear because people knew there was a strong likelihood he had been killed. Gordon said she had mixed emotions about Dunham's death. She was never tried in the court of man, Gordon said, but I think she was judged by God, and his wrath is more punitive than any judgment or penalty she could have gotten in the courtroom. I don't think she had a pleasant or happy life. Yeah, because she was disgusting. And trust me, God got to her. Parker is the last surviving witness to Till's abduction. He and Till were staying at an uncle's home in Mississippi when Till was taken in the dark of night. Parker said Thursday that his heart goes out to Dunham, which I don't know why. As a person of faith for more than 60 years, I recognize that any loss of life is tragic and don't have any ill will or animosity towards her, Parker said in the statement. Even though no one now will be held to account for the death of my cousin and best friend, it is up to all of us to be accountable to the challenges we still face in overcoming racial injustice. He has a good heart, but I still don't like that woman, and she's burning in hell right now. Last year, President Joe Biden was proud to sign the Emmett Till Anti-Lynching Act to make lynching a federal crime. White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre said Thursday, "The president is committed to dealing with racial hatred," Jean-Pierre said. Dunham had an unpublished memoir. In an unpublished memoir obtained by the Associated Press in 2022, Dunham said she was unaware of what would happen to Till. The contents of the 99-page manuscript titled, "I Am More Than a Wolf Whistle," was first reported by the Mississippi Center for Investigative Reporting. Historian and author Timothy Tyson of Durham, North Carolina, who said he obtained a copy from Dunham while interviewing her in 2008, provided a copy to the Associated Press. Tyson had placed the manuscript in an archive at the University of North Carolina with the agreement that it not be made public for decades, though he said he gave it to the FBI during the investigation. The agency concluded in 2021. He said he decided to make it public after some of Till's relatives and other people doing research on the Lafourche County, Mississippi courthouse in June 2022 found an arrest warrant on kidnapping charges that was issued for Miss Roy Bryan in 1950 but never served. So they found an arrest warrant and for kidnapping charges, but it was never served to Miss Roy Bryan. I wonder why. Racism. Tyson said in a statement Thursday that Dunham's precise role in the killing of Tills remains murky, but it's clear she was involved. It has comforted America to see this as merely a story of monsters. Her among them, Tyson said. What this narrative keeps us from seeing is the monstrous social order that cared nothing for the life of Emmett Till, nor thousands more like him. Neither the federal government nor the government of Mississippi did anything to prevent or punish the murder. Condemning what Dunham did is easier than confronting what America was and is. America today is still racist. I could tell you right now, I may be out of base. Some people might say I'm out of base, but I know what I'm talking about. Because America is still racist today. It's still hard for people of color like myself to find success with such limited movement. That's why it is what it is today. People say whatever happened in 1955 was 1955. Well, 1955 is still happening today, just minus the lynching. In fact, it may not be physical lynching. It's a social lynching, and it's a social lynching of colored man's income in this country and resources. That's all I gotta say on that point. Activists sought criminal charges against Dunham. Last year, members of the new Black Panther Party and other activists began showing up at addresses associated with the aging Dunham, including in North Carolina and Kentucky. They were there to serve unofficial warrants for her arrest and trial. Weeks after the unserved arrest warrants was found, the Office of Mississippi Attorney General Lynn Fitch said there was no new evidence to pursue a criminal case against Dunham. In August, a district attorney said a Lafourche County grand jury declined to indict Dunham. Till's cousin, Priscilla Sterling, filed a federal lawsuit against the current Lafourche County Sheriff, Ricky Banks, on February 7, seeking to compel him to serve the 1955 warrant on Dunham. In a response, April 13, Banks' attorney said there was no point serving the warrants on Dunham because the grand jury did not indict her last year. The Emmett Till Legacy Foundation, run by some of Till's relatives, posted a blank black square to social media sites Thursday after news of Dunham's death was reported. What happened in 1955 was a miscarriage of justice. And now the last surviving member of the gruesome three is finally gone. They are in all in hell together, serving their sentence for what they did to Emmett Till. But it's people like them, and what they did to Emmett Till was what was done to many people of color in the 1800s, the 1900s, the 20s, the 30s, the 40s, even the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, the 90s. And now we are in the age of social lynching, where it's easy to just lynch somebody based on the fact that, hey, we're not going to talk about the color of their skin so explicitly, but whatever feeling that we have inside about that person, we'll do everything in our power to hold him or her back in the bottom. And that's what it is. That's the new America. If you read the new Jim Crow, you'll see what I'm talking about. Definitely, this is what it is. But again, my prayers goes to Emmett Till. You know, it took all those years for his murderers to die, and now they're all gone. So, God rest your soul, Mr. Emmett Till, Miss Mamie Till Mobley. God rest your souls in heaven. For your enemies that hurt you on this earth, may their soul rest in hell. This was, thank you for listening. This was another episode. Thank you.